Friends and welcome to Net Forum. Today we are going to study the very important one more topic, that is known as the variables and keywords. The concept of variables and keywords play a very important role in writing a program, because the variables here are basically not static type, they are dynamically typed, means that we can assign variables in any way, and we don't need to write the type casting of the variables at the point of declaration. Let us see. Suppose this is our IDE, and we write, this is the command prompt of Python, we write a equal to 10. Then we don't need to write integer or float or any other thing while writing the particular variable. Or we can write in this way also, b equal to say Ram. So what is b? B is a variable and it is storing the string Ram. We no need to explicitly write whether it is a character or it is a string, whatever, because the interpreter is intelligent enough to understand that whether the variable would be an integer or a string. So these are some very important points we have to keep in our mind while writing the program in Python. Further, let us have some basic variables are very much robust in itself. They are dynamically typed, they need not to be typecasted. These are some very important properties of variables. Now let's talk about the keywords. There are 37 keywords in Python 3.7 version. Now what are keywords? Keywords are those words which we cannot change, which we cannot modify. They have to be written as it is. And some of them are as follows, like def, print, and we can say if, while, and if is in small, it is not in capital letter. If, while, anything you can write for. So in all together they are 37 keywords, but the important properties of keywords are they are case sensitive. We have to keep this thing in mind. They are case sensitive, and that means we have to keep in mind while writing the keywords that we should not change their case. Means that all the keywords have to be written in the lower case. So we have to keep this particular thing in our mind. When we will write programs, we will going to encounter the keywords as they will come while writing the programs. We will going to focus them in detail as they will come in our programming. So let's now write the first program and see what are the keywords we encountered. So the first program in Python are as we all know that the first program is normally written as simple program, is print print hello world, print hello world, right? So print means to print a particular thing, and hello world means hello world is simply a string. The idea is that when you write, this is a command prompt and this is print hello world. Now how you're going to start, how you're going to install the Python, that is very important. There is a website. Python.org, of course you have to written in small letters. I have written here in capital letters. You can go there and simply download the Python, or you can download from Jupyter notebook. You can download Jupyter notebook. You can download a big IDE, as in Java we have NetBeans. Similarly, we have Anaconda. And you can write explicitly, you can download Spider. So in this way, you are going to have multiple options to download the Python. Now let us take one more example, which shows that how you can add two numbers in two different ways, right? Firstly, you take the input from the console, and secondly, you take the input directly from the screen, right? Addition of two numbers. Suppose this is your ID. Suppose I have taken A equal to 10, B equal to 20, and you just write A plus B, and when you print the, of course here also you have to press the enter key, you get the answer 30. So this is the one particular way to write, to add two programs, at two numbers from the desktop or from the IDE. Means that directly when you pass the values into the program, right? Passing values directly into the program. Listen, the best way to learn programming is to learn it from the board, then do the practical. We cannot directly learn from the laptop or from the computer. So now this is the taking values from console, input output console, right? Here you have to write in this way, A equal to integer, means you have to typecast input, enter value of A. Remember there, we don't need any type of semicolon here. So when you press the enter here, you just have to give the value. You give the, whatever value you will give, it will come and stored there. Then you write B equal to integer input, enter value of B, and then you make the addition and you get the answer. Whatever values you will take, suppose you take 3 and 2, you will get 5 here. Now what is the point to be remember is that, point to be remember which is normally asked in the examinations is that, the value when you will enter into the input stream, the interpreter, this is the interpreter converted into a string form, right? This is the input, it gets converted into a string form. So this has to be typecasted into integer, because the value which you will enter into the string, into the input stream from the console is treated as the string. This value is a string, it is a string. You convert it, you typecast it into integer, and they get stored A plus B, and you get the final answer. So you have to keep this particular thing in mind. So what we have learned? We have learned how to take value from the console, how to take values from the program itself, inside the program, and there are the two very important ways to take the input values. So slowly and steady we are moving forward, and now in the next lecture we will going to introduce you to the strings, use of strings in Python, basic operations of a string, and then we will move to the very important structure known as list in the next lecture. Till then, stay with me and subscribe my channel and be with me in the journey of Python. Thank you.